As an advanced medical practitioner pharmacist practicing in family medicine, I've seen firsthand just how making small mistakes when taking your blood pressure readings can give you incorrect readings. And I've seen it so many times with patients. So here's what we're gonna do in this video. We're gonna test some common mistakes that a lot of patients make when taking their blood pressure reading, such as crossing your legs, sitting with bad posture, talking during the reading, drinking coffee beforehand, and holding in a full bladder. We're gonna put those to the test, doing it properly and doing it incorrectly, and showing you just how much of a difference it makes in your blood pressure readings and just how much it can give you incorrect readings. So let's start the experiment. So first things first, we're gonna first take my blood pressure reading correctly. So we're gonna do everything right. That's going to be our baseline basically, and then we're going to compare that reading to when it's done incorrectly. So first of all, before I take this blood pressure reading, I followed the 30-minute rule. So 30 minutes before we take our blood pressure reading, no smoking, no caffeine, no exercise, and no eating. So secondly, notice that I'm sat comfortably with my feet flat on the floor, my back is supported, my arms are resting and at heart level, and also I've already had a bathroom break. I don't need to go to the bathroom. Third of all, you can see the position of the cuff is correct. It's about two fingers above my elbow. It's snug, but it's not too tight. Just tight enough so you can fit two fingers underneath. Using the correct cuff size is critical, since a wrong size is the most common mistake I see. Fourthly, you can see that with our A&D medical devices, the cuffs, we have a marker on them, and this is aligned with my middle finger for the perfect placement. And fifth, before I click start, you can see that my arms are supported, I'm not moving, I'm not chewing any gum or food, I'm not talking, and I'm not blocking any of the tubes. This is the gold standard in getting an accurate blood pressure reading, and then I click start. Now in this video, throughout the experiment, to make it a fair test, I'm going to be using our A&D Medical Precision Check Pro device. So that's the device I'm going to be using throughout the video. I particularly like this device because it also has something called our trademarked tri-check technology. Basically, when you take a blood pressure reading at home, you should ideally take three readings 1 minute apart. What I love about this device is that our trademark tri-check technology, you can turn this on so it automatically does all three readings at 1 minute intervals, and then it averages that result and stores it for you. So it makes life really easy, but it gives us the most accurate reading as well. Oh, and by the way, this does comply with the American Heart Association's recommended measuring method. So now before we begin with the experiments, I'm just going to show you my tri-check average basically. Hopefully you can see that it's 123/78 mmHg. That's my average blood pressure that I've taken when I took my blood pressure correctly. And my pulse is 79, okay? So this is going to be our baseline now. So 123/78 mmHg, we're going to be comparing my readings to that. So every experiment we do, we're going to compare it to this baseline now. So let's begin. So experiment number one, taking our blood pressure readings with our legs crossed. This is a very common mistake I see many patients making. Sometimes as well, I've had patients in the past that just have this, you might call it a nervous thing that you do, or like a nervous tic that you don't realize you're doing, but shaking their leg whilst taking their blood pressure readings. Both of these can have an effect on our blood pressure readings, giving us incorrect readings. So as you can see, I'm taking my blood pressure here. Again, for all the blood pressure readings I'm gonna be taking in this experiment, I'm gonna be doing tri-check readings, all right? So it's gonna take three readings with the 1 minute intervals between them, and it's going to give us the average. Okay, wow, so results are in. Now remember, my baseline was 123/78. After I crossed my legs, you can see my results became 129/75. So I hope you can see that. So our systolic blood pressure went up to 129 when previously it was 123. So that's a pretty significant increase right there just from crossing our leg. Straight on to experiment number two, no back support. I see this often, patients not having their backs fully supported when taking their blood pressure reading. And as you can see in this blood pressure that I'm taking, my back isn't supported. And let's see what the tri-check readings actually show. So again, remember, baseline was 123/78 mmHg. Obviously this test was no back support. And we can see my blood pressure went up to 126/71. Okay. So there's a 3 mmHg increase in our systolic blood pressure by not supporting our back. So I hope we're starting to see a bit of a trend now of what actually happens when you don't do things correctly. So imagine doing a few of them incorrectly and what result that's going to give. And moving straight on to experiment number 3. Let's see what happens when you take your blood pressure and you're speaking. This is quite a common one, actually. It even happens in clinical practice. You know, it's always a little awkward when you're taking someone's blood pressure, and patients also feel a bit more comfortable if they're speaking, but really you have to do it in silence. So let's see how this affects our blood pressure. As you can see, for this experiment, I'm actually FaceTiming my fiance Melody. So let's see how much of an effect that has on my blood pressure. Okay, so results are in. Firstly, thank you, Melody, for talking to me during the test and the experiment. This one's a really interesting one. So remember, our baseline was 123/78. So that's the reading that we got when we did everything properly. Talking to Melody, you're probably not gonna like this. My blood pressure went up to 136/80, okay? That is a massive increase in blood pressure. 136/80 compared to the average that I got of 123/78, if I'm correct. Yeah, so you can see these little things make a big difference. Talking is a definite no-no when you're taking your blood pressure. And if your medical provider is speaking to you, just mention to them, tell them that you saw the A&D Medical video on the experiment and they said not to talk during your blood pressure because it can increase my blood pressure significantly, and I'm not being rude. And I'm telling you, no medical provider is going to mind. They're going to fully understand what you mean. So it's definitely a good point to mention. Okay, so now we get into the good stuff. Experiment number 4, and that's caffeine. I'm going to be having caffeine. I've already started having it. Remember the 30-minute rule that we spoke about at the start, that included caffeine. So no caffeine half an hour at least before taking your blood pressure. Also remember the 30-minute rule included, you know, no talking, no chewing, no eating, no exercise, all that kind of stuff. So what I've been doing is I've been drinking this coffee for the past 20 minutes now, I'd say. So let's see what kind of effect this has. Okay, results are in. Remember, baseline 123/78 millimeters of mercury. This one is quite shocking, actually. So you can see here, caffeine caused the blood pressure to go up to 141/72. So that is a very big increase. And I've said this many times in our other videos as well. When we drink caffeine, it spikes our blood pressure. Our blood pressure goes up for about 3 hours and then comes down again. If you have caffeine again, it's going to go up. So these are the effects of caffeine. And these are the reasons why we have the 30-minute rules. And we say to avoid the caffeine and to reduce your caffeine intake, to reduce your, lower your blood pressure. So this experiment's been great because we're actually starting to visually see the effects. So now let's move on to experiment number 5. And that's taking your blood pressure reading with a full bladder. I can't lie to you guys right now. I really do need to go to the bathroom because I've had about 4 or 5 cups of water right now. So I really do feel like my bladder is quite full. So it's going to be quite interesting for me as well to see how much of an effect this actually has on our blood pressure reading. And the results are in for the full bladder experiment. I'm telling you, when I was doing that blood pressure, I was really needed to go. So remember again, baseline 123/78. Results are in, 131/75. Okay. So I really hope you can see that. So again, blood pressure's gone up. You know, when we need to go to the toilet, the bladder and the organs there, they're all contracting, and that's going to basically increase our blood pressure. So again, everything that we've seen today are things that sometimes we forget about and sometimes we might not do correctly. And the beauty of today's experiment is we're actually starting to see visually the numbers and how much it affects blood pressure. And I've found this experiment truly, truly interesting and fun to do. So next up, I want to give everyone a pro tip about blood pressure monitors and making sure that your blood pressure monitor is validated for accuracy. So it's on the validated device list that we call VDL for short, by the American Medical Association, Hypertension Canada, and the British or Irish Society of Hypertension. Because believe me, a lot of the blood pressure monitors you can buy at Amazon are not on the VDL list, so they're not accurate. I have personally been using A&D Medical blood pressure monitors in my very own practice for years because, one, they're an absolute workhorse. They really are. And secondly, they are on the VDL list. They're on the validated device list. It's done through formal studies, making sure that the readings are accurate. By the way, in case you guys don't know this, A&D Medical, we invented the digital home blood pressure monitor in 1977. We were the people that invented it. So we definitely know how to get accurate readings when it comes to blood pressure monitors and our other devices. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you found this video as informative and as entertaining as I have, because this has been a real eye-opener on just how much doing these little mistakes can make a big difference on our blood pressure readings. By the way, there is a part two of this video as well. We're gonna do some more experiments because there's quite a lot of other things that patients generally sometimes do incorrect. So definitely watch that video if you found this one useful. We also have loads more cardiovascular health videos on the channel where we discuss how to use your blood pressure monitor, we discuss in cuff sizes, we discuss natural ways to lower your blood pressure, everything cardiovascular we discuss on the channel. So definitely do check them out. If you know anyone that find this information helpful as well, please do share it to them. And to learn more about A&D Medical and our fantastic health devices and our product range, I will leave a link in the description below. Definitely do check it out, give it a read, learn more about us. We are committed to helping you stay healthy with reliable products. In fact, all our blood pressure monitors come with a 5-year warranty if you're in the US, Canada, or UK. As we always say at the end of every video, A&D Medical, discover precision.